Don't forget to hit subscribe and change it to past tense.
Hi Speechies, it's Lisa. Welcome back to Speech Fairies. Today I have a game that I bought last year and I never opened it, so I thought we should open it and have a look. It's called Crazy Toaster and it's from Little Tykes Games, Catch and Match Toast Game. It's rated 4 and up, 2 to 4 players. Crazy Toaster. It reminds me of the Crazy Blender. They might be kind of released at the same time. I have no idea what I paid for it, but it is new. Well, I thought we could crack into it together and see if it's any good. I always pick up these action games because they don't make very many of them anymore. They used to make a lot of them in the 90s, but not as many anymore. Oh, here's an overview of some skills. You've got Start the Toaster, Catch the Toast, and Match the Toast on your plate. Don't catch the stinky fish. Oh my. Includes one crazy toaster, 40 pieces of toast. That sounds like lots of turns to me. Plates, pans, forks, spoons, cups, and sticker sheet. Great for functional vocabulary. That's what it looks like. Hope everything's in there. Ta-da! Instruction sheets. I can see the pans and the spoons are nice and big. And there's the toaster. Looks like he needs his eyeballs. And there's some little parts inside this box as well. So we have a green looking bowl. Maybe one of his eyeballs. There's our toast. Oh, there's a stinky fish. There's the toast pieces. Done. I could use the box, but it's unlikely I'm going to be able to get it all back in the box anyway. So let's have a look at the. I'll get everything out of the bag. Oh, yes, it is part of the Crazy series. So we have the Crazy Toaster, the Crazy Blender we have at work, the Farm Memory Matchup. I don't have that one yet. That's one with the little haystacks. It looks so cute. And then we've got Hot Hoops, which I've not seen. This one's 4 and up, 5 and up, 3 and up, and 5 and up from littletykes.com. How to put together the crazy toaster. Let's see, assembling the toaster. Oh, look at him. So yes, the cup and bowl are his eyes, and then we put the eye stickers on top, and the forks are his hands, and it looks like the spoons are his feet. Wow, he's super wacky. I'll put that together and I'll show you in a sec. I might use the spoons rather than use them as legs, but we shall see. So on the bottom, we put the spoons as little feet. And there's two. What a waste of a spoon. That's okay. Here's the sticker eyeballs, different sizes actually. So the big one goes on to the green bowl, and the small one goes on to the blue cup. And looks like his nose is an advertisement for Little Tykes. It's like a timer. On. There we go. Okay, so he's ready. Each player gets a plate and a matching color pan. Mix all the toast cards and place them in the slots located in the top of the toaster, inserting 10 of these in each slot. So there are 4 slots, so I guess that equals 40 pieces of toast. So we'll do blue because we have a small table. So we've got, everyone's gonna have a placemat like this. Oh, it's nice that they're a little bit different. So there's jam. Orange is actually my favorite color. Well, there isn't an orange pan, it must be yellow. So we've got a green plate, a yellow plate, a red plate, and a blue plate. So let's put blue on top. And our blue pan goes beside us. Is see the different types of toppings on the toast. So I guess that's a good idea to mix those up. So we've got jelly. They're sticky, so I'm gonna have to lay them out. I have to lay them out to kind of mix them. Marmalade. Shuffling, but it might work for the first time. Ooh, so maybe some Nutella or chocolate spread. I don't like it, but some people might. Ooh, bacon. Or you could just call it meat. If someone didn't like that. You can get turkey bacon now too. I actually prefer turkey bacon to regular bacon. And now we're to eggs. Definitely a breakfast game. I don't have very many breakfast games, so that's good. I like the functional vocabulary in here. And then we've got the sticky fish. Ooh, I do not want sticky fish toast. Unless you really like anchovies. So there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 7, 8, 9, 10. So that stack will go in the toaster. Woo! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Stack will go in this toaster. Spot. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So they're all kind of mixed up. I'm very curious how this is going to work. And then the last pile goes in the last spot. Okay. Now what? The first player is the person who wakes up earliest in the morning. The first player will push the toaster's nose down to begin the timer and start the first round. Oh, so here we go. So this is one of those fast-paced games. I think once I start the timer, things are going to be popping and we're not going to be stopping. What I would do for this game to get them to slow it down would be get them to earn their toast. And when they have 10, then they can put it in the toaster. We could even get 10 more turns and get the second stack in the toaster. Depends how many players we have. All players will hold up their pans to catch flying toast. The pan should be held horizontally with a straight wrist. So yes, some of my preschoolers with other games that I have, they'll hold it like this. And then they won't catch anything, so you have to kind of coach them to have it like this. It says to avoid big arm movements by sitting down. Up to 4 pieces of toast will randomly pop out. Only catch the toast with the pans. Do not use your hands. I wouldn't tell them that. I would let them do however they wanted to. Toast will sometimes bounce out of your pan, but for little ones, they can keep it. If you get a stinky fish, you lose one of your slices of toast from your plate. If you have no toast on your plate, then select one from the outlined square. Place the selected toast on the table, toast side up. If the stinky fish lands up on the side of the table, all players race to exchange toast from their outlined square with any slices that are on the toast side of the table or floor. Kinda goofy. So I still want to find out what happens. So let's watch and see if I can catch any. I don't know if one will come out at a time. Oh, it totally does. 2 came out that time. So you can slow down the gameplay, which is nice. Oh, it doesn't want to pop. So it's a bit stiff, but it's nice that only 1 or 2 pop out at a time. So I could slow down the gameplay and get them to earn a turn, I guess is the way to go. So we can work on whatever goal you're working on with speech and language, and then you get to push down and wait for it to pop up. There we go. And if it matches something on your plate, then you can put it on top. Good prepositions. You can also put the pans all around. We could have some in front of him, and some beside him, and some behind him. And we could catch all the toast, just given those 4 spots. so we can decide where we want to put our pan and use some prepositions there. So that was really cute. And then they go in or they go on the table. You never know. Lots of good sounds if you're working on pan or pot for simple CVCs. So yeah, this is a really cute game. I really like it, and it's easy to put together, easy to start. It's got lots of pieces and it equals lots of turns. So that's one of my favorite new games. Awesome. I'm happy I picked this one up. I'll have to keep an eye out for the Crazy Blender to add to my collection. The biggest theme section that I have is food games. There's so many different food games out there, and they're getting wackier and wackier. I like to keep it simple. This is nice functional vocabulary. And we can even talk about how we put them together. The spoons go under, and the arms, the forks go on the side, and the cups go on the front, and the bowl goes on the front. Those are his eyes. And that's a really cute game. So, if you like this video, please give us a thumbs up, comment down below your thoughts, and don't forget to hit that subscribe button. We're always adding to our Speech Fairies family. Everyone is welcome. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you very soon. Bye for now, everyone.